Natalie and Derica, welcome to the show.
Thank you
for having us.
Thank you for having us.
A lot of people go missing in America every single day. A lot of people know that this happens and it's an unfortunate story. A lot of women predominantly go missing in America every single day. But what this documentary talks about is an issue that I feel started to get a lot of attention around the Gabby Petito case, and that was, why do black women, why do women of color not get the same coverage when they go missing? And this is what this documentary talks about. This is what your foundation talks about. So let's start with that before we get into the documentary, if you don't mind. The Black and Missing Foundation. Mm-hmm. What is the work that you do?
We are a nonprofit organization, and for the past 13 years, we have been sounding the alarm that people of color are disappearing at an alarming rate. And Derica and I have joined professions. I'm in public relations, she's in law enforcement, to bring awareness to these cases, because these cases are being swept under the rug. Our community isn't aware of it because we're not getting the media coverage that's needed to help find these missing individuals.
I mean, it seems impossible. You know, when I was watching the documentary, I couldn't believe it when parents were saying, no, police have turned us away. Police have said, your child isn't missing. The person in your life isn't missing. They've run away. Derica, you were in law enforcement. You were once a police officer. As somebody who works from the inside, what do you think is going wrong?
You know, there is a lack of training when it comes to missing person cases. Quite frankly, they're not taken seriously when our community are reported missing. They're labeled as runaways. Runaways are not receiving the Amber Alert. There's no sense of urgency. And if you really looked at a flyer today, missing, runaway, the message is not created equal. You know, there really isn't a sense of urgency to share this information for runaways. And so we want to get rid of that classification. We also need to look at the reporting structure. We all know that the first 24 hours are the most critical moments when someone goes missing. And, you know, across the country, a lot of jurisdictions require you to wait 24 hours before you can even file a missing persons report. So there's a lot that needs to change, especially when it comes to missing persons, because there's not enough resources dedicated to that particular unit.
Let's talk a little bit about the resources. I mean, there are people who will say, look, obviously we want everyone found. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't want anybody to be missing. But at the same time, so many people aren't missing, and so many people have run away. And, you know, how do we make sure that police departments aren't wasting resources on people who aren't actually missing? How do you find that balance?
Well, we need to take these cases seriously. What are they running away from if they leave voluntarily? What are they running away from? And ultimately, what are they running away to? We know that children who are on the street, within 24 to 48 hours, they're propositioned for sex. And they have to survive. So they're in the sex trade business, which is a multi-billion dollar industry. It could be any one of us that could go missing, could be snatched or just disappear. Mm-hmm. And we would want someone to take our case seriously.
It appears even when you know, the police may not take it seriously, the media takes it seriously. You know, you'd always watch these stories of missing people, you know, a missing girl here, a missing boy there. You'd always see these stories that would get media attention. However, time and time again, many people in America, many people in the African American community, many people in Native communities have said, guys, we don't seem to get that attention. The media doesn't cover us for days. We don't become front page news in that way. As two people who are working on not just the issue, but the PR side of the issue, what do you think that is? Why do we not see black girls who are missing being covered for weeks on end on major news networks?
Well, from a PR perspective, again, it's changing that narrative. Mm-hmm. And ensuring that our missing are household names too. And that's the piece that's missing. We're not saying that other people are not valuable, but can you name any black or brown missing person, you know, that has disappeared? So we can name the Natalie Holloways, the Chandra Levy, but can you name the Akia Eggleston? Can you name any person of color? So we have to take these cases seriously. And we need more diversity in the newsroom. We need people to tell the stories that look like us.
So, you know, obviously, you know, media companies and these executives, they've been asked these questions. And they say, no, look, race has nothing to do with it. We're merely telling the stories that our viewers want to pay attention to, because we, at the end of the day, we are trying to make people watch our show. Mm-hmm. When they say that, it seems like they're shifting the blame to the audience and saying society doesn't have an interest in finding black and brown girls. Society doesn't have an interest in these stories. Do you think that that argument holds any weight?
Well, I think, again, that the decision makers are deciding what society wants to see. Yeah. They're not asking us or anyone out there. These families, as you can see in the documentary, they are desperate.
Yeah.
You know, missing persons isn't a black issue. It's not a white issue. It's an American issue. And even in the documentary, you see these families. We're out there with them distributing flyers. You know, the Natalie Holloway, the Lacey Petersons, the Chandra Levy's, the Gabby Petito, they have people coming in droves, flying all over the country to help search.
Right.
And we can't even get law enforcement to take the cases seriously. We can't get the media to shine a spotlight on these missing individuals. So if not us, who?
What I appreciated in this documentary as well is you see the effects of not treating the, you know, the cause, but going after the symptoms, in that oftentimes people will talk about fighting sex trafficking, you know, fighting these rings that are taking young girls from everywhere, as you say, black and white, mm-hmm. and then putting them into prostitution forcefully or whatever it may be. And yet, if they started looking early enough, they may find them before that becomes the case.
Absolutely. I mean, that is our message, to be proactive. And we are hoping that the docuseries is a call to action. We know what the issues are, so how do we move forward to address it so this does not continue to be a pandemic? Because it is a pandemic,
right,
impacting our community. But how can we move forward to make it better for everyone else, to, you know, generations to come?
And what are the steps to move forward? When you look at concrete things that we can do in society, whether it's the police, whether it's the media, et cetera, what are some of those things that we can do to try and alleviate this problem?
Well, one, the media can start covering our cases, and we say less is more. Less of one individual or one particular race, less equal the playing field and cover more stories. Don't wait until it trends, help it to be a trend. And law enforcement, we want to challenge them to look at the way they classify these cases, which really impacts the resources that they add to the case. Mm-hmm. And we want our community to get involved. We are fire starters, and we need them to work alongside us to help find and bring our missing home. So there's so much work that we all have to do. And visit our website at bamfi.org. See who's missing. Like these cases. Help them go viral and share it within your network.
We're calling for our community to be that digital milk carton. Share this, you know, let's face our own biases and share these profiles, because someone knows something out there, and we need that someone to come forward to help us end this nightmare for these families.
I love that. Let's create those digital milk cartons. Well, yeah. Natalie, Derica, thank you so much for joining me on the show, and congratulations on telling a story that I think many people definitely need to hear.
Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Black and Missing is available on HBO and HBO Max.